Don't get upset. You didn't get yourself in the fucking... in it, did you? What happens in the final? You answer a question and then they won. It's too late. Brownies won it. You didn't, the final's over now. It's a quick fire trivia. Do another one. Not do it, no, because...
What, another trivia question?
Oh, I could do another trivia
what question. What game mode in Blackout used nothing but swords and speed boost? What game mode in Blackout used only swords and speed boost?
There was literally no such thing.
Yes, there was. How do you not remember that? That was my favorite game mode.
Thank you, I appreciate that. Thank you. Spectra mode. Oh,
yes.
God. Oh my God.
I do you not remember that? I can't believe you didn't remember that.
God.
I was gonna make that the final one, but I figured you'd come up with some.
Oh shit, I remember that.
Yeah,
that was amazing.
The Spectra game mode, it was fucking awesome. You could just like zip across the map, slice people.
I'll bring you down for ping, Shelly. Yeah, but seriously, that was something else, actually. That was.
It was. And honestly, it blew my mind that like not as many people really caught on to it and liked it. Because they wanted to shoot. But as soon as it came out, it was like you could just be a ninja.
You could move like a god in that
game. You could. You could just freaking zip like, I don't know, probably like 30 meters in front of you.
Can you turn on game
What's
chat?
What's going on, chat, here? By the way? How we doing? Right. Tommy Chong, nice to see you. Good Brian thing. Shaw.
Right,
yeah, Lolly.
This is $100 on the line.
Okay.
For you not to die once in this game mode.
What?
Take this time to ready up.
Alright, fine. No, I can do that. That's easy.
Yeah.
Oh, it is easy, but Luke's not gonna like it because I'm not gonna fucking push anything. I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna be that little bitch in the background that just follows you. Like, hello!
Just gonna follow him like, hello!
Yeah, I'm gonna. I'm just gonna walk. I'm literally just gonna follow both of you guys.
I don't think so now. Maybe mid-season, but I don't know. I have hella doubtful right now.
Todd Craft, how we doing? Adam Ray, what's going on? Zach Dances, that game mode was cool. It was, man. Spectre game mode was fucking awesome.
So I gotta say Bukowski every single time.
Sticks and Stones reminds me of the old Dr. Wu games. Todd Craft just said Sticks and Stones reminds me of the good old Dr. Wu, or Mr. Wu games in Verdansk.
Apparently you get one free life if you sing Nitro's a bitch song.
Oh, I got you. Every single time, if I die, I'm gonna sing that. But I won't die.
You get one free life.
I get one. One time. All right, I got this. Don't let me die.
Well, you have to do the song before.
Oh, I have to do it right now? I got you.
You have to do it right now, yeah.
I'm fucking born for this shit. All right, I came out the womb with this song in my hand. Luke's a bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's throwing a hissy fit. Oh, bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's sucking another dick. Oh, bitch. He's a monumental bitch. Nitro Duke is a bitch. I'm gonna die if I don't leave this spot. Bitch, bitch, bitch. Money, 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 bitch. What do you mean, where's the song? I have to land down.
Land down, bro. Fucking
I'm landing.
Bring it back, bro.
Bring it, bring it, bring it back, bring it back. All right, I'm in. A three, a two, a one, and then we're at, bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, throwing a hissy fit, oh, bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's sucking another dick. Bitch, bitch. Yeah, little bitch, little bitch, little bitch. Oh yeah, every time I tune into his stream, yeah, he's throwing another hissy fit. Oh,
yeah.
Luke's a bitch. Monumental bitch.
Yeah, you got kicked for inactivity, motherfucker.
Oh, you fucking idiot.
I got kicked for that!
You got kicked for inactivity.
I moved!
You got kicked for inactivity.
One, two, three, Jazz a bitch! Yeah, monumental bitch! Yeah, kicked for inactivity. He didn't move an inch. Oh, bitch! Monumental bitch! JareBear got kicked for inactivity because he didn't move an inch. What do you mean? I'm doing the whole team. Dictator's a bitch. He doesn't watch porn. Every time I go into his room, I'm really fucking bored. Yeah, fix a bitch. He doesn't watch porn. Every time I go into his room, I'm really fucking bored. Yeah, Luke's a bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's throwing a hissy fit. Hayden's is a bitch.
No, Dad, that's a stroke.
Oh. Every time I tune into his stream, he's having a stroke.
With his hand.
Yeah, so Levick fix a bitch.
Yeah, fix a bitch.
But he's good folk. Even though every time I tune into his stream, he's having another stroke. It's Vic. And he's good folk. Every time I tune into his stream, he's having another stroke. Oh, Vic. He doesn't watch porn. And every time I go into his room, I'm really fucking bored. Yeah, it's a bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's having another stroke. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, killing it. Killing it right now.
I mean, hey, you join the game, bro. You wanna.
Alright, I'm coming. I'm on my way now.
I mean, Keith Curtis proved 5,000 stars in the chat for that. I just think.
Well, there you go.
Different, dude.
Nailed it.
I think that song hit different, man.
It does. It does hit different. Like.
It just cheats, huh?
Like, motherfucker. Yeah, he's a big old bitch. Yeah, bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, his body don't fit. Oh, on the screen. Hayden's, yeah, he's a big old bitch. But he's probably the nicest.
Yeah, well, he's a big
but he's our big fan.
bitch.
Dude, it hits big. Keith Curtis literally sent 5,000 stars over here too, saying literally the best song ever. It's the greatest song in the world. Everybody in God levels, bitch. Apparently, that's what we came up with tonight. And then Luke wants to go on that YouTube fight. He might not make it, cause I think he'd pass out. It hasn't worked out. And Chloe told me that he didn't work it out. You know what I'm saying? It just didn't work out. Didn't jam it in there.
Just cause your good material enough. Was shit without me, bro. That's what it is.
My material works well with you, man. It does. Know, it's been doing it since back in the day, baby. All right?
Yeah, it's like, I'm a singer, but not really, you know? Like,
you know what another good one was remember the fucking, what was that? We never even, it was the Mystic Tree or whatever.
You mean, that wasn't a song, though, that was a...
That was like a story.
A poem.
It was a poem.
You mean, the dragon with one ball.
The dragon with one ball. And on top of the elderberry bush.
Down by the mountain.
It worked out great because the helicopters actually have like a ball on the front of them. Todd Trapped with 310, Nick with the 200.
Says you guys need to record a label with that song.
Oh, we got it.
Oh, yeah.
So, the world is ready.
One day, maybe. I mean, it's more like a TikTok song, isn't it?
Enemy soldier nearby.
We'll get more. We'll get more songs. I think tonight might just be a song night.
The greatest hit was a hit with an SKS.
Yeah. Finger bang bang with the SKS. I'm gonna finger bang bang you in the ASS. Finger bang bang you all night long. Finger bang bang it till the day is done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, that was a great one.
Yeah.
I had somebody make me sing that the other night. Gregory Dean says you must be smoking and drinking something good. Hey man, you know what? You do what you gotta do, baby.
Different time.
Yeah man, back when the game was fun.
And views were good.
Views were great. Holy shit, views were good. Platform was good.
Bang it, bang bang in the SKS. I'm gonna bang 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 in the ASS.
Finger bang bang you all night long. Finger bang bang it till the day is gone. I'm gonna finger bang bang with the SKS. And the SKS never ended up being meta, like one time. I think it was literally one fucking time, and that was it.
Supply box.
I can't die. Holy shit, I'm fast. I don't want to die today.
But tomorrow, I'm totally okay. But
tomorrow, it's totally okay. Do I just test it and, like, literally run next to Luke so he better kill the guy so I don't die?
Yeah, why not?
I think that's better content.
Yeah. Try the number one.
China, that was a good one too!
How did you even forget that, dude?
China number one! China number one! China number, China number one! He stank! China number one!
And then it was just... ad lib from that moment, wasn't it?
Yep, pretty much. It was whatever we added into it.
Grenado!
I pick you up. China number one.
China number
Who has more people landing with?
Top of
Bill. Oh, I see him. Wait, I'm not supposed to die.
Yeah, we are so fucking blessed to have this fucking game mode on.
Yep. Oh, dude, I can't. I'm not supposed to die. So if I don't, I don't want to fuck. I'm literally off ping, so my hits don't do very good. Enemy
soldier.
I can't believe they brought it back, too.
I've seen that dude, bro. He's like, come here, boy. I can smell you.
Bum, bum, bum. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, they brought it back, didn't they? Because it was just easy games.
It yeah, it is.
It was just a vibe, wasn't it? It was just a good vibe. And it's like, something that's not really been done on this game before. So
not worrying about hackers anymore. Yeah. Just kind of enjoying fucking around. Hey, all right, we're gonna mess with this guy.
You'll be tracked by an enemy team. Tread carefully.
Oh, you got fucking the dick down.
Put the fuck on me.
Yeah, put the fuck on me.
You didn't watch the whole Call of Duty Next event, did you, Jay?
No, I didn't. I had to go get my daughter, so I missed like almost all of the Warzone part of it. Objective isn't in
reach. Yeah, I saw it all. I saw every single thing. It was fucking amazing. It genuinely is a better game. It is a fairer game as well. It's a more skillful game. And I do believe the anti-cheat will work. I do believe. I don't think it will be perfect. I think there'll still be cheaters. I don't know to what extent.
New safe zone highlighted.
Oh yeah, I don't remember to say go cocky every single time. I do apologize. That's my fault. I'll do it again next game. Sorry, Keith. Yeah, it's because honestly the song is just on my head. I do apologize. Sorry, Keith.
Oh, what?
I'll make up for right now.
Is he gone?
Me here. This is a stun. Yeah, never mind now.
Objective is to eliminate the bounty target.
He's pushing
target.
Now on the hill.
Uh-oh. Ruh-roh.
Your teammate was sent to the gulag. You'll fight for a chance to redeploy. Don't become prey. Your teammate is in the gulag now.
Oh, mate, all I can say is the funniest streamer that we watched, right? The funniest hacking streamer ever, and we were literally pissing ourselves laughing. Was Nadia, right?
Nadia.
Female streamer who's literally rage hacking, who calls herself the movement queen and the best Call of Duty Warzone female streamer. Yeah, I shit you not, I have never seen someone call tech support more than anyone else in the land of a LAN event in my whole entire life. If you really want to know something that literally, basically, based on just the precedence alone on how basically messed up she is, like a fake.
Your teammate is redeployed.
Just know 100% that Nadia was the biggest Call of Duty embarrassment. Yeah, that was staying there. There's nothing more insane than Bukkake. Yeah, true. All right, so I shall give you I should give you what you want. All right, JareBear, we need to get another.
All right.
Fucking loadout.
Well, I need you guys to come with me so I don't die.
Why don't you give me the money? Yeah, and I'll go load out.
All right, I'll give it to you down here.
Drop it. I'll come get it.
Cash.
Now stay with me. Come close.
Enemy right. Dropping into the AO. Grenade out.
I got stunned.
Loadout drop inbound.
I got executed.
One behind you.
Go back and turn around and go for the buyback. Turn around and go for the buyback. Turn around and go for the buyback. You're not listening to me. When I tell you to turn around, you fucking turn around and go for the buyback. That's it.
You're up next. Ready up.
That's it.
Yeah,
go for the buyback. Go for the buyback. Go for the buyback. Trey, go for the buyback.
And your fight is over.
Just do it. Stun it and go for it. Stun it and go for it. Stun it and go for it. Stun. Stun. Yeah. Stun. And Jesus Christ.
Ooh.
Why would you buy the wrong player? Come on, one more player, buy one more.
Your team can pay for your release.
Hey, listen here, baby. Yeah, John, listen, I'm a total because I'm cool, right? Because I didn't go to
By the way, chat, sorry, I'm not paying attention. Seems like there was a lot of Tarkov influence in there. There was Tarkov, there was everything. From what I saw, you got Rainbow Six with some of the game modes that they had going on.
Oh shit.
Did you realize there's a whole fucking team here?
Game with the amateur fucking Haytons right here. Yeah? Hate you, Haytons. Chair, buy me back. Oh, if you buy me back, baby, I'll
bro, I ain't gonna be able to buy that. There's no money. Where can I get money? This bounty?
Grab the bounty and then if they die, then, you know. Grab that shit on the floor right there. Boom, 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 money. If anyone sees you with that melee in the hand, they won't take you seriously. Go left. Yeah, baby, keep running like that. Keep running like that, baby.
You like that? You like the way
I
run?
The best in I think the best player that played was probably. Probably Diaz Biffle, but I don't think he's legit personally, but other than that, he was legit.
Unfortunate.
He probably played the best. Keith, I'll give you Bukkake, mate, or every single death, okay? Or kill, sorry.
Bukkake! Bukkake! Alright, I'm gonna use the bathroom real quick, chat.
If I was at that event, you see me win it, mate. Did you not see Breadman, that guy was on the 31 Mortar Street? Yeah, but I just thought, you know, that was multiplayer. You know, I'm talking about Warzone, bro. Thought Stone played all right. He did all right. He did what was expected of Stone Mountain. Good enough. And he was having fun with it, you know? Who knows, Wes? I don't know, Stephanie.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Hayden's that shield is bigger than the monkey character.
I know, Rob.
Zach, 5,000 stars, $54. You go through Cash App, Venmo, PayPal. Proxy will be good. Proxy chat will be good, but could you imagine the racism, like stream sniper racism? That would be disgusting.
Luke's.
The amount of stream snipers that will run up to you and just say,
Luke's a bitch. What do I think? Luke's a bitch. That's what I think. Nothing. That was beautifully done. Uh-huh.
That was like some good harmonies, man.
I mean, I'm gonna hit you good with it again, H.
Luke's a bitch.
That's the first one right there, okay? You like that? And then I come in with that secondary, just above.
Luke's a bitch.
And then come in with that little bit of...
Luke's a bitch. Luke's a bitch.
And then this one.
Luke's a bitch. Luke's a bitch.
And then you could hit it with like a...
Luke's a bitch.
I think that was beautiful.
That was incredible.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll be here all night. Probably not all night, but for a while. Did he mute up? He didn't even hear any of that? Where'd he go?
No, I'm still here.
Oh, you're not even impressed by that? Dude, I'm pouring out my heart and soul with music for you. I should write a full song for Luke right now. How would it go?
Every day, yeah, yeah.
Yeah? You ready to hear my song?
No, no, no. Come on, let's play.
Huh. Serious time.
Located a supply box. Good acquisition. Hunt the enemies before they hunt you.
Well, this guy just ran by me.
Are you still there?
Oh, you little bitch.
New objective identified. Your teammate is in the gulag now. If they survive,
the cocky.
Bro, I cannot get this fucking dude. That's how he wants you to yell at Luke. All right, can you put some emphasis in it? I want to hear it from the soul.
Got gas moving in. Your teammate lost the fight.
Wow.
Now they return to base.
Let's ride!
Primary objective accomplished. All supply boxes located.
Why won't it let me frickin' execute him? What the hell? I'm just smarter. Martin says, can you play through Fire and Flames? And he says, by the way, happy birthday, Jer. Hope you're well. Bro, I didn't even know it was my birthday. It's my birthday today. Fuck yeah. My birthday. I didn't even know that. Stunned one of them for you, Luke.
Got gas.
dude.
Stunned.
Fucking carry sticks, bro.
One more in this room. Ah, ping's off. Hard to do it.
This is the gulag. Survive this, and you get to redeploy.
Can I get tech support?
You have to wait for now. And you return to the front line, but if you lose, you're done. Fight your way out of this or capture the objective.
Got him. Great, Hamza.
Toss and stun.
Drag out.
We got key.
Kind of fun to say.
The enemy team is hunting you. Don't become afraid.
I got a dude chasing me.
Teammate lost the fight. Now they return to base.
Attacks. Level 36 fresh account. He has got aimbot, dude. He has got aimbot. That guy has got aimbot. If no one believes me, there is such thing as aimbot with melee weapons. It gives you extra reach and it gives you extra rapid fire hit markers. If you didn't know, it's very, very true. And it is very possible. Aimbot with melee allows you to have extra hits, faster hits, and that guy's got a 36 fresh account. That's completely fresh, new non-prestige. This person's actually got cheats, by the way.
Let me die.
Very lucky. Very fucking lucky. I'll be back. I don't know why it was able to actually out-hit me with that device. Hey, come on, take your time, mate. You're being chased. You got the guy that aimbot's chasing you as well. That's the one with aimbot. You're going to die. You can challenge him if you want to, but that is the one with aimbot.
Hello, this is tech support. Hey, old man, will you help you, Nadia?
Jump. Here you go.
She had her own tech support team. It's just like it's lagging. I don't understand. The ping is... I have 200 ping.
So literally take just breathe for a moment. And just challenge this guy straight away. Just challenge him.
Dude, fucking caddy sticks, dude. They reach so far.
Was it that same dude? The lady?
Caddy the baddie.
Level 38.
Yeah, level 18, mate.
See like how that guy gets the last hit on me? I mean, I was stunned. But let me see how early he got it. Yeah, fair game. Fair game. On that one.
Bukaki!
The problem is that I just don't think we're going to win. Like, I just don't think we're good enough as a team to win. So it's just like kind of a bit boring because it's hard to win. So.
It is hard to win, yeah.
Let's play one quads. Actually, fuck it. We'll just play sticks and stones. It's just... You know, it's just a little bit difficult. There is a lot of sus bullshit. Plus, I don't know. I feel like the stream doesn't like sticks and stones. Like, I feel like it's one of the hardest. Like, anytime I do sticks and stones, like very rarely do we hit us, like we struggle to get the stars for sure.
I don't know. I mean, I think it's pretty entertaining. You're on, Colin. Don't hate me. Luke's a bitch. Not a metal bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's throwing hits in the air. Oh, bitch. Yeah, monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, he's sucking another dude. There you go, Colin. Nick Box with the 500 says nut. Keith Curtis with 1400 says again. Yeah. I gotta do it again. It'd be great if you sing along with me too, though. A one, a two, a three, a four. A Luke is a bitch. Monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, throwing a hissy fit. Oh, bitch. Oh, monumental bitch. Every time I tune into his stream, throwing a hissy fit. Wes Brown came over from Luke's chat. Can you roast me, please? All right, I got you. Wes Brown is super cool. Inside his head, he rides down the street, stops, and then says to his friend, hey, can you take a picture of me? Oh, that's right, he had no friends. So he propped his phone up to his shoe. And that's why he can't see his right and left leg, yeah. Taking pictures in the street by myself. My name is Wes Brown. Oh, now I'm cool. Facebook gonna love my cool ass profile picture. There you go, Wes.
I'm glad. Nah, listen, I would do it right now, but I'm like fucking, like, my energy levels have just gone like kaput. Like, I'm like, oh, yeah.
You didn't get much sleep, to be fair.
I mean, I did get loads of sleep, but then I got up at like 9 a.m, played like fucking Destiny 2 like for like 6 hours, and then stayed up for Call of Duty, the event, did that, then went live. And don't get me wrong, like, everything's all good, bro. Like, everything's clutch, you know, the stars are pretty decent, even though we've had none in like about an hour, but it's pretty good.
It's been good. I mean,
it's just, it's one of those things. Like, I'm still like recovering.
I'm just trying to feed you the energy, buddy. That's it.
I mean, look, don't get me wrong. Like, the energy's where it needs to be, but you know, like, I think the thing that kind of sucks is that fact that Vic's internet went out, you know? Like,
that does suck. You need that duo feel.
Yeah, he says, don't get ill with streaming. Ah, no, bro. I've got a star goal to hit, Andrew, though. You know, I'm sitting at 57,000 stars, so that's cool, Nick. Keep it up. You'll be able to play in the raids with us and stuff. But no, it's just the fact I'm still recovering from COVID a little bit, so, like, when I exhaust a lot of energy, I start hurting a little bit, and my concentration goes a little extra, a bit weird and stuff, so it's not easy for me. I'm trying as hard as I can to keep myself above the water, as it were. and hopefully we just get some good games going in and stuff. Like, I apologize if the stream just suddenly changes into a little bit of a low point.
Wes Brown, so very soon I will be actually doing the hosting of the God Level tournaments. We're still getting that all figured out.
Yep.
But yeah,
100%.
He said, because he said, he said, you're right, Jared needs to host some of these events. I got it, baby.
Killed me, bro. Fucking killed me. David, I'm pretty sure he could. I don't know. Like, legit. I was the illest I've ever been. The illest I have ever been, Frank. It still even hurts me to this day, dude. It's actually fucking like, it's actually nearly caused like a little bit of like, a bit of trauma. Basically like of how ill it made me. It's kind of like kicked off a potential like sort of like PTSD vibe or like a bit of depression vibe mixed in. Not because I'm like actually depressed, but I think it put a lot of trauma on my body. And my body just genuinely doesn't like what it's done, you know, what it did to it and stuff. Like, I won't lie, I'm not saying be scared of it, but it definitely really definitely fucked with my head. Like, I was ill for like 7 days straight with flu, and feeling like I had to go to hospital and everything. Like, obviously, I'm not saying, hey, feel sympathy for me, but I am being dead serious. Like, if there was something that I don't wish anyone to get, is the same shitty feeling I had felt with the current, with that particular COVID, obviously. Hey, you're a bitch, man.
I'm alive!
Yeah, so it's one of those situations where I'm still recovering, and for me, it allows me to breathe. Like, if I can break my Stargirl right now, yeah, that will literally be like a breath of fucking fresh air. Oh man, I'm sorry, it takes a while sometimes to recover that long COVID, but from what I've heard, most do, so I wish you well. Hey, appreciate you, Frank. Appreciate you.
Your teammate was sent to the gulag.
If you want to get some games in the next Call of Duty, let me know by yourself, because I'd love a snapback for the community, and we can get some games in the new Call of Duty Warzone. Up to you. I guess anyone as well, if any of you guys want to buy stuff from Merc, I'll give you some games in the new Warzone, free games. Thanks, Rox. We have a look exactly, like, how...
Nick Box with 200 to 200 says fart, fart.
November 16th.
2 months.
Turtle, right finger, okay sign, sweat droplets, whole eggplant, sweat droplets, heart.
In 60 days, we will be playing...
I dig it.
The end of the season, essentially.
Yeah.
Interesting. You got that guy coming for you right now, Trey.
Smack my bitch up. Anyway.
Frank, I appreciate that with fire and stars though, man. You really do. Seriously, thank you very much.
What's that?
But yeah, no, like, I'm looking forward to Warzone 2.0. I think it's got a lot of potential. You know, it does give me a bit of anxiety figuring out whether
it didn't work
that
time.
Gonna actually be legit or not, but that's about it. We'll figure out. You know? I think there's gonna be a lot more views, a lot more opportunity. It's one of those situations, isn't it, you know?
Give me your money!
closing in. Relocating the safe zone.
Throwing stun.
Start out.
I'm gonna get this guy quick. Quickly. He's down.
Why is this guy? Are you kidding me?
It's because you jumped.
Yeah, no jump.
Alright, I'm out, boys.
You're gone?
Yeah, man. I'm out. I'm done for the night.
Alright, buddy.
Luke broke me tonight, mate.
Sorry, haters, ain't no one loves you at all. I'm sorry, haters, that you ain't got long left on this earth, you fool. I'm sorry, haters, for all the food you consume. I'm sorry, haters, for the feud you abuse. I'm sorry, haters, for being part of the game with your fat show fingers. Touch my body, you're sorry.
I hope you don't die. Sleep well tonight, baby.
Oh, shit. That was fun.
So,
forgiven.
Was that a... Would you accept my apology?
I do. You're forgiven. That was so from the heart. I could feel it right down.
That was deeply from the heart, bro. Deeply from the heart.
There's not going to be much else out there, you know, like I told you, it's worth it. You know, 1,000 stars was going to come in and you got something quite magical, you know, like anytime, you know, when you're there, you know, heavy breathing, nearly dying, you know, you could play that song and it might be the last thing you listen to. But at least you know that when I'm not carrying your coffin and I'm just going reverse, throw him in the fucking yard. Right, then you dug the big hole. Yes, sir, we've dug the big hole. Yard him in there. Yeah. But thank you very much for donating some stars today. You have helped me out. I'm sitting at 59,000 stars at the moment. I don't know. Today, I just so on edge today. Like, it's so difficult for me to be able to, like, play. It sucks that Vic isn't on, though. I tell you, it's fucking bum.
I think that sucked all the energy out because we were actually quite keen to like have a huge session on Sticks and Stones, have a bit of fun, but then it just went tits up, mate.
Went tits up, bro.
It went tits up, bro.
Tits are flopping everywhere.
But your community's gonna come in clutch, bro. Watch, you'll still smash a star goal. Let's go.
I want to go skinny dipping in a frozen lake
with you,
Haydens.
Right, Haydens, can you go to bed now? We've done your fucking bit. Piss off.
Oh, right.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Haydens.
Goodbye, boy. You see what I mean, bro? He's been bullying me all
fuck
night,
off,
mate.
Man. Yeah, I apologize to you. Stop fucking lingering. You fucking look like you're going to fucking take up all the oxygen out of the room. Hurry up. Get out.
Linger as long as you want, H.
You know what? I'm going for a piss, and when I come back, you better be fucking gone.
You know what's sexy and hangs up?
You better be fucking gone when I come back!
You know what's sexy and hangs up?
You're fucking bros!
Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Alright, this is gonna take me a minute, hold on. We gotta really work on this one if we're gonna do it. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. Hello, my name is JareBear, and I'm super cool. I think that works. What else can we do? What else can we do? What else can we do here? What else can we do here? Luke's got a tiny pee-pee. 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 That's beautifully done. I don't know any other way you can do that that's better. That's a four-part harmony right there. Any song requests with my four-part harmony thing right now? What is, isn't there like a Beatles song that uses fucking harmonies like that? Jacob says that was fire. You like that? I like that. I told you. It's pretty good. Luke's gonna be so happy when he gets back. Alright, well, let's do that. Because I'm happy, clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy, clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy, clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy, clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy, clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Unable to establish a secure connection to the host. All right, that sucks. Can you sing Disturbed? What is the one that they do? I see a little silhouette of a... I see a little silhouette of a man. 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 I see a little silhouette of a man.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Please stop.
I'm waiting for you.
Right. Anyway, right. What was I going to say? I think I actually figured out why Dr. Disrespect didn't get invited.
Because his penis was too big to be in room full of virgins.
I have genuinely...
Come on, what is it?
Well, first things first, I'm pissed off about the PlayStation pre-order because they've got a samurai skin, but you can only get it if you pre-order the PlayStation version. Yeah. And you're like, for fuck's sake. So
yeah,
that's
I'd have to like look for a damn PlayStation.
Yeah, no, that's a little bit annoying, but it is what it is. But no, what was I saying? The genuine what was I saying?
You figured out the main reason why Dr. Disrespect wasn't invited.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Right. The reason why is because how many streamers were there? 200, right?
200.
Okay. How much of the percentage of the streamers were going to be on Twitch? 80%. It is against terms of service to say the name Dr. Disrespect by contractual law in the realm of Twitch, which is a fact, right? So I truly believe that the reason why they did not invite him was because of the amount of streamers that would have been streaming to Twitch.
I'm Dr. Disrespect. I wasn't invited to Call of Duty. I'm Dr. Disrespect. I wasn't invited to Call of Duty. I'm Dr. Disrespect. I wasn't invited to Call of Duty. I'm Dr. Disrespect. I wasn't invited to Call of Duty. I'm Dr. Disrespect. I wasn't invited. I like it. It works. Yeah, that's probably why. Chat, I'm going to use the bathroom.
Dr. Disrespect explained it on his TikTok. Oh, go on then. What did he say? Block list player. How's it going, Brian Rager? What's with block list players? How we doing, my man? He's got an echo. Twitch banned me for jizzing on my keyboard. Fuck me. Yeah, that's a pretty unbannable thing, isn't it? It's not bannable. It's just part of the job, right? Well, go on then, Paul. Give me the lowdown. Come on. Did you see the new MW announcement, Brian? You know what, Brian? If you're there, I'd love you long time. Yeah? All right? I'd love you long time if you come and save me today. By the way, I'm only saying that as a cheeky little, like, remark, only because at the moment they've removed fucking... what'd you call it? Budget on the platform. So, yeah, it sucks. But yeah, if you want to save me or help me, I'd love you every single day. I would tickle your balls and make you fucking extremely happy.
What the heck? That's the second time it did that.
Yeah, it is.
Doesn't want me to play with you.
It doesn't want us to play together. It doesn't want us to look up each other.
I just want to play with you.
It's not with the fucking thing. Stop. That's so annoying. Like, no, like, that's fucking super duper unbelievably fucking annoying.
Bro, it's instantly like having your own tracking in the background, all right? Family Guy did a whole bit about it. It's like the tuba bit.
Stephanie, it says, Luke, what did you make of Warzone 2? I thought it was disappointing. I thought it was fucking amazing, and there was nothing there to be disappointing about.
I know you do,
what
Lally.
What did you think was disappointing? What did you think was bad? What did you think was awful? What did you think was sad?
Bro, can you stop singing? That's really annoying.
Excuse me, I'm a fucking great singer, so shut the fuck up, you little bitch. When you can get more than one kill, you can tell me what to do, you little witch.
Hmm. When you get signed to a record label for singing, you can tell me what to do, bitch.
I do get signed for record labels for singing, and it goes like...
Nailed it. That's a good point, Richard. Keep doing it. It's amazing. If it pisses him off, that's a win-win.
Danny said, Activision told the 3X his chat's too much shit about the game, so wasn't invited to the party. Yeah, I did hear something about that, right? But the thing is that actually true, though, right? Do you know what I mean? Like, is that actually, you know, a real... John, I don't know. You know, is that a real thing, though, right? You know, I chat a bit of shit about the game, you know? But at the same time, you know, thank God for that. Ladies and gentlemen, $190 from Brian Rager. Thank fuck for the fucking blessing that we've just had there. He's just taken us up so high. If you, any of you guys want to help us out and
take
be alongside
casino,
Brian Rager,
Brian.
Please go ahead and put 100 stars in the chat. To help us out. No, Twitch, H-Doc. No, I know. I truly believe that it was literally just to do with the fact that they had to give him a reason, but I truly believe it is the fact that it's... Wow, this is actually not loading. Holy shit.
I'm going to back
No, no, we're going to start again. No. Restart everything. Patchy, thanks 100 stars. Come on, folks. If Brian can throw $200 in the chat, you can come in clutch and throw a fucking 100 stars in the chat. Look, it all goes to kids with autism and disabled children. The new Warzone was announced today. Why not come in clutch? He says, now, I don't think that's it, though. I think that's what they told him. But I truly believe that okay, put it this way, right? Hear me out for a second there, right? Right. Yeah. If you didn't get invited to Call of Duty, right? The biggest star. And you're going to be curious why you didn't get invited, right? Did you know he could sue them? For ostracization. If they said the reason why we're not inviting you to the Call of Duty event is because there's other streamers there that can't say, you know, the TOS, like the terms of service, I think you would be able to legally sue if they came up with a reason saying the reason why we're not inviting you to this event is because other creators.
You would only be able to sue if the terms were literally the fact that because he was on Twitch, he couldn't join. That would be the only way that he could sue. If it was just because he didn't get an invite, then he'd have to prove that.
Yeah, but that would be, I think the reason is, because the thing is, that would be ostracization for sure. That would be definitely some form of like bad thing. But I think by them saying verbally that, no, the reason why you're not coming is because you chat shit. That's basically like the nicest way of basically saying and giving him a reason, even though that might not be the actual reason. Understand? Like, so that's like a way of saying, fuck off. You're never going to be like, yeah, it's like a fuck off without, because legally you had no leg to stand on. If they say we don't like you and they say that, then that's basically the nicest way of saying you're never going to be invited ever again.
Which is asinine to think if they never invite fucking Dr. Disrespect to any of these events again, they're out of their mind.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that legally they probably won't tell them the real reason. So by them being extremely obnoxious and rude, you understand, basically gives them amnesty in that narrative. Ian, thanks for 200. Jeremy, thank you for 1,000. Fuck me, thank you.
Pete Ratcliffe with the 90. Appreciate it.
Are you Ash?
I don't know. I think it's bullshit that they didn't invite him. And they invited Ninja, who doesn't even play fucking Call of Duty.
Do you think you deserve to be invited? Absolutely. Yeah, of course I deserve to be invited. But at the same time,
to be invited.
At the end of the day, right? I'm not one of the favorites. I'm a black sheep. Okay, I'm one of the oppressed people, right? That's what God level is. God level is a black sheep mentality, right? You are not a white sheep butt licker, rim, nose, butthole face, motherfucker, simp. Yeah, I am a person that truthfully wears my heart on my sleeve. I am not perfect in any fucking way, I can assure you. And I am a black sheep. So therefore, you know, I will not be part. Listen, at the end of the day, right? Okay.
Daniel, what's going on, my man?
Favoritists. They pick and choose who they like. And unfortunately, because the game, if the game was legit, and I mean super legit, right? Super, super legit. People would be bowing down to the gods of Call of Duty, right? And I don't just mean me, I mean other people too. People that are great at the game would be respected in the highest regard. Unfortunately, it is the opposite. If you are the best in the game at the moment, you are one of the best cheaters and you've got away with it for a very long time. So therefore, you know, it's the people that are legit that they are scared of. That is the problem. If the game was super, super really legit, everyone would change their way. It would be like, bro, we want you on our team. You're so good. Not like, oh, you're just really good with cheats on. You understand? And that would be one of the things where, unfortunately, the dark side of the force, you know, benefits much more financially through growth, fun, ease, money, fame. It's too, too easy. So therefore, someone like me, I am a obstacle.
Hey man, was doing voice dubs over the commentary today. Shit was fun.
Legitness.
I'm gonna have to check that out. I spoke with Hitman recently, chat.
Isn't it? You know,
I was talking to him about how I was talking to him about how Ninja sits at 800 viewers on this platform, and the fact that that is even a thing is uneasy for the people that actually stream on this platform. So, you know, 38 viewers, 40 viewers, whatever. It's a beautiful thing. I love all you guys. If you go back 2 years, I was sitting anywhere from 500 to 1,000 CCV. But the biggest thing that I'll say is it's an amazing feeling to have a community like ours. But it's also kind of a scary thing to think that the actual platform itself can't even get enough traction for somebody like Ninja to get over 800 CCV. And me and Hitman were talking about that, and he agreed like 1,000, I mean, he said 1,000% on everything that I was saying, and it's very uneasy where we're going in the future right now. Like, I think more than likely we are going to start doing YouTube content. I've always wanted to do that. I think it's going to be a great thing. But yeah, the way that Ninja is sitting at 800 viewers, that freaks me the fuck out. As a streamer, that freaks me out big time.
That, you know, a developer would call me up and go, Luke, I love your gameplay at the moment. You're doing so well. You know, I look forward to seeing you. You know, I wish it was more like, you know, a real world where, you know, people were like proud to see people play better. You know, I want to see people call out 1v1s. I want people to feel the anxiety to win, the passion, you know, I want there to be almost like a tears of joy of salvation. I want there to be a sport ethos in the game. And unfortunately, you've got these like mini little drug dealers over the internet, like these youngsters that are in their 20s to 30s. They look like they need a wash. They look like they've got money, but they don't know how to dress themselves properly.
They've got dandruff on their shirt while they're doing interviews.
They're just, you know, and I'm not saying that that's what makes these people suck, but it's the fact that they earn more money than a surgeon. They earn more money than someone in the military or the forces. They earn more money through cheating and lying and deceiving, and they make more money through, you know, than all these other people. And they don't look the part, they don't play the part, they don't feel the part, and they are taking up an opportunity away from someone that could be in that position, that could be so passionate about gaming and so good at games that they deserve to be seen. For example, right, me. Right, you could label me or put me into any category that you so wish, right? But I believe that I am so unfucking believably really legit at this game that I believe I am one of the best, if not the best, in the world at this game, right? You can choose your opinion. You can choose who you think's legit or not. Up to you. My actions speak louder than words, yeah? I believe I am the top 10, 5% legit players that play Warzone. By Miles. Jer, can you host it? By Miles, by the way. And I believe that in my head. Now, put this out there. If you didn't believe it, then you could never be the best, right? You understand? So you have to believe it in order. It's like a fighter. If you went into fighting not thinking that you're the strongest man in the world, or you're not going to win, you know what I mean? It's all affirmations and things like that. But I truly believe it. Like, I truly fucking believe that that in any LAN environment or anything like that, at the end of the day, that's what I fucking believe. Truly believe. But at the same time, let me tell you something before I start up, right? When I was playing Blackout, and it was Blackout, it was on console. I'll give you an insight. I wanted to be the best in the world, right? I wanted to, and I want to tell you the truth. And I wish I could fucking give you the severity, right? But I think me, Y8, Picnic Basket were probably the best players in the world at that game. You know, you got youngsters, gangsters, he was quite good, Examza was quite good. But I still believe, like, hands the fuck down, that I believe I was probably one of the best players, if not the best player, in certain updates. I think basically because the meta used to be like, you know, there was no loadout on the Battle Royale, you had to like make and find attachments, and then certain guns were meta. And there was basically a 2-week period, right, where I hands down was the best.
With the AUG, right?
With the ABR.
ABR.
And
yes.
ABR. And there was another update that had the updated, I can't remember what it was called, the SMG pistol that came out. And it was like, it came out with the SWAT gun at the time.
Yes. I'll admit, I started watching you right around the ABR thing. And by far, you were the best player that I watched.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Movement with the zips and everything, like, it was great. It was fucking admired.
And I know it.
It was, I know it. I mean, even Picnic Basket at that time, because obviously he held the world record, and then you had it, and then he had it. It was very cool to watch. That's really what got me into Call of Duty and streaming.
Yeah, absolutely, right? So what I'm saying, yeah, please die up, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I got it.
Now, what I'm saying is that when I wanted to be the best on Blackout, right, I, like, just hear me out for 2 seconds, right? I was so anxiety anxious about being the best that I used to, my brain was on another level.
Don't know who that is, Martin.
I would go to, in the shower, think of Call of Duty. I'd have a shit, I'd think of Call of Duty. I'd sit at dinner and I'd talk about Call of Duty. I'd be on the phone to people playing and talking about Call of Duty. I go to sleep.
You disappeared.
And I'd have nightmares about Call of Duty. I wouldn't even have sex with my other half at the time because my brain was so focused on Call of Duty. Remember, I'm autistic, right? So my high functioning autism, if it hits a certain pinnacle, it becomes like a psychotic obsession. And I know it sounds really dumb. Like you might think, oh, that's not real. Trust me, the passion, the drive of being the best or wanting to be the best, I've thrown up 7 times, 8 times. I've had panic attacks. This was Blackout, right? This was Blackout. Panic attacks through wanting to be the best. And I shit you not, it was severe, you know? Severe. The anxiety, the passion to be so good was there. And people don't realize that when my brain goes to that level, it's Mike Tyson. It's fucking insane. You know, it's another breed of passion, and the drive is so up there that it makes it seem like a fucking fictional, like, fairy tale that I'm telling you. No, it's not. People, when you are on that level, of being so fucking good, and your brain is just so there. People can't actually comprehend the passion, the fucking love, the sheer arrogance, the confidence in it. It's something that you have to be born with, or you have to just truly believe. It's like, you know, it's the closest thing when people say that they've spoken to God, right? That is the feeling that you get in your heart, as if there was a God talking to you and you believed it. You know how those people out there that, I'm not saying that you don't need to believe in God, but you know what I mean, like the extremists, the fucking extreme, you know, tinfoil hat level religious people. Like, there's religion and then there's like absolute extremists that you're gonna like, that, you know, Templar, they're gonna fucking kill you because you don't, you know, that next level extremism. I had that 100% for Blackout and being the best and things like that. And in Warzone, you know, like, if you really want to be semantical, yeah, I actually was world number one on Modern Warfare 2019, right, for overall COD stats. That includes wins, losses, aim assist, headshot ratio, kills, win streak. I was world one. I used to have 17,000 concurrent viewers on multiplayer, and I was boosted on Facebook massively. I was partnered, massive contract, everything. Obviously, the platform changed and relationships changed, and I was just absolute monster on multiplayer. Like, seriously, I had rappers and fucking, you know, artists in my DMs. People wanted to play. I had contracts coming up to my eyeballs. I was getting, you know, well, the kids were earning, as in, like, the stars and all that. We were earning, like, 6-7 Gs in a stream. It was a different fucking time. I was a monster on console. And essentially, then PC came along, and there was cheats and VPN day one. Whether you believe or not, it's true. And I was viewed as the streamer with a tinfoil hat that was literally making up all this nonsense come along. And the sad truth is that I spotted the hacks and VPN day one, week one. And it was week one and day one. It was, truthfully. And I was the absolute epitome of this guy that was held in the highest regard of Call of Duty, that all of a sudden turned into this bitter, horrible individual based on the amount of trauma and abuse that I would have endured from Call of Duty. Now, I know that again sounds very, very stupid, but again, being high functioning autistic, your brain just goes on another level where it is just, again, it's very difficult to actually describe to you, because of course, if you're not autistic, then I can only say that imagine taking bath salts or being on an absolute, you know, line of cocaine for 24/7, but being passionate about, you know, how legit the game is. So no, like for me, you know, it's one of those situations, like the passion was there. So I am truthfully looking forward to seeing if the next Call of Duty is super legit. You know, and JareBear, there's a
I wasn't sure if that was, I wasn't sure if you were
no, so I'm just trying to explain to you that's what it takes to be the best. It really isn't about the cheeky 30 bombs and 40 bombs, and you know, to be able to be on that level, you have to sacrifice family, holidays, time, love, the amount of you know, not arrogance or whatever, but the amount of sacrifice that you have to make to actually be the best. It's just fucking, you know, it's just on another fucking level. Like, the psychological aspect is huge. And you know what? Yeah, anyone that knows sport knows what I'm going on about. So, you know, that's what gives me anxiety, is that. I just thought I'd let you know that that's where my headspace at. That's where the passion was. And, you know, hopefully you guys see that again, you know, and hopefully we can all be honest with ourselves and we can live a better life where, well, I can live a better life knowing that when I'm
Joe
playing that game.
Joe Maldonado with the F.U. Brando. The fuck is Brando?
Yeah, that everything is above fucking board. I'm going to turn the audio up every any second.
Brando!
Your teammate has failed. and stun.
Remember, that's my gas. Turn around now. 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 Oh, sorry.
Couldn't do it. Nah, I was just a touch late.
One shot. One shot. What happened to the mod with the long hair? I like the guy, man. I don't know which one. Ash, what are you saying? Who's the top five Warzone players? I don't know, mate. To be fair. I don't know.